Me Too activists are calling Betsy DeVos out for the Grinch this Christmas season for her new rules for college campuses and how they deal with accusations of sexual assault and harassment. Supporters of these changes say that this rollback of the Obama rules that were unfair, they believe, to the accused is a good thing. But opponents are launching a full court press to try to stop that from happening. Actress and activist Alyssa Milano narrated a Christmas-themed video to attack the education secretary's plan. Watch this.
This holiday season, Betsy DeVos sent a lovely gift to the students of America. New Title IX guidelines. Here's a little story about it. Title IX protects women. That much she knew. And something so good simply won't do. Sweep assault under the rug. Walk back student rights. Protect predators when they put up a fight. So go ahead, put one more thing on your list of holiday tasks. Take Betsy's gift and shove it up her.
Lovely, right? But not every feminist agrees with Milano. My next guest wrote this in an editorial in the New York Times. I'm a feminist and a Democrat, and as a lawyer, I have seen the troubling racial dynamics at play under the current Title IX system and the lack of due process for the accused. Ms. DeVos's proposals take important steps to fix these problems. Laura Bazelon is a law professor and is the author of Rectify, The Power of Restorative Justice After Wrongful Conviction. Laura, thank you very much for being here tonight. What's wrong with what Alyssa Milano is getting at there?
The problem here is that we have been hopelessly divided into team accuser and team accused. And what needs to happen is what all should be on the same team, which is team process, team due process. What we should care about is getting to the truth. And right now, in too many cases, in too many colleges, under the current regulations, that is not happening because clients like mine are being subjected to what essentially amounts to a star chamber, where they are not told what they are accused of, they are not given a hearing, and they are not given any chance to question the people who are making the accusations. And then, subsequently, they are expelled and branded rapists.
Yeah, and their life is basically over. You know, I've seen cases where the person goes to their new school that they worked hard to get into, and within days, they're also ejected from that school because the word has now followed them of what happened at their prior school that they felt they were falsely accused of. This is from NARAL. They say the new rule from Betsy DeVos would require universities to allow accused sexual abusers to cross-examine and re-traumatize their victims. This is absolutely sickening. This is the kind of falsehood that is really poisoning this discussion, is it not?
Yes, that is not true. So how it would work is that both sides would have the right to cross-examine each other through an advisor. So we're talking about an indirect process that would presumably be subject to reasonable limitations. And that's not the only mistruth that's out there. Other organizations have claimed, including the ACLU, that these proceedings are going to favor the accused, which isn't true. All of the rights, again, are reciprocal and meant to benefit both sides.
You know, it always seems to me when I look at these situations, and I've interviewed, you know, a number of young men who have been in situations that they felt were completely unjust to them. You know, and the problem is, as you, I think, so rightly say, you really need to strip away the sex of both of the people involved and just look at the evidence in front of the case and figure out who was wronged, who was actually wronged.
Right. And to do that, what you need to do is have some way of testing the truth of the allegation. We don't in this country accuse, condemn, and banish people based on untested allegations. That's just an undemocratic principle. That's not the way our country is supposed to work. And unfortunately, in too many schools, that's what's happening.
All right. Tell me, is there anything in this new proposal that you don't like, that you think should be changed?
Yes. So I'm not completely embracing every single suggestion. I think there is absolutely room for improvement here. My point is that the due process protections are completely in line with case after case of courts reversing what schools have done, reversing expulsions because they say the students were denied any semblance of a due process. However, there is plenty of room for improvement. So, for example, there should be some redefinition of what constitutes sexual assault. I think the DeVos definition is unduly narrow. I also think it's incredibly important that we collect collect data on race and socioeconomic class, because in my experience and the experience of my colleagues, it is people of color upon whom these punishments fall the hardest. And yet, because the Office of Civil Rights and the Department of Education doesn't collect data and doesn't count, we don't know empirically what's going on.
Very interesting work that you're doing. Thank you very much, Laura. Great to have you with us tonight. Thank you.